Hi, and welcome to this week's episode. I'm so excited to have you guys on board. If you are a new subscriber, welcome to the family. We hope to make you feel part of us. If you are a returning subscriber, thank you so much as well. In this week's episode, we are discussing social anxiety. And remember, if you are going through a mental health issue and you'd like to talk to an expert, kindly call 1199. It's a toll-free number. I'll be linking it here on the screen and also in the description box down below, and you will have a friendly voice at the other end of the phone who will talk to you. Call 1199. It's completely free. You'll have someone to talk to 24 hours a day if you have any issue that is disturbing you. Someone may ask why I'm not showing you guys the book I am reading currently. So I decided to pause the books I'm reading right now. I decided to internalize of the books I have read. I have read so many books this year. So I decided to internalize the books I have read this year. And also, as I internalized the books, I decided to binge watch movies. I'm not a movie person completely, but I have decided to start watching a lot of movies, which is what I am doing currently. I've watched a couple of them. Right now, I'm watching the movie 13 Reasons Why. I have watched it again, but because it has an aspect of mental health, that's why I keep watching it again. So yeah, that's why someone may ask why I'm not showing you the book I'm reading. I decided to internalize on the books I am reading. So in this week, we are discussing social anxiety, also known as social phobia. Social anxiety is something I am going through, something I go through. And the issues I talk about here are the issues I go through or someone in my circle is going through. So today we are discussing social anxiety, also known as social phobia. I mean, there are lots of anxieties, different types of anxieties. We have performance anxiety, pandemic anxiety, transition anxiety, separation anxiety. But today specifically, we decide to talk about social anxiety. So it's an anxiety related with social issues. But before then, let's understand what is anxiety. Anxiety is a feeling of worry or nervousness about an event or an uncertain outcome of something that's going to happen. Simply apprehension about the future. You don't know what is going to happen. So you have that fear, you have that apprehension, you kind of become irritable. Yeah, so that is what anxiety is. This week we discuss social anxiety, social related anxiety. That's basically what it is. And anxiety presents itself in three areas. The first one is physiological, basically how your body feels, how anxiety feels in your body. We have cognitive, which is the thought process. The third one is behavior, behavioral changes, how you react or how you act when you have anxiety. So it's physiological, how your body feels, how it feels in your body, cognitive, your thought process when you're going through anxiety, and behavioral changes, how you behave when you're in that
what
space.
Are some of the thoughts that someone with anxiety goes through?
The first one is feeling like you're worrying about something bad and you don't know what, or feeling like something bad is going to happen but you really don't know what is that bad thing. You can't place a finger on what that is. And this is something that happens to me a lot of times. There are some times that I find myself listening to sad music all of a sudden, a lot of anticipation about the future or bad things that are going to happen. And it's simply in your mind. Then there is numbness. And this is something that happens to me a lot. You completely feel nothing, completely numb. And in these numb moments, I find myself talking to myself so much because I have to keep reassuring myself. I have to keep fighting this numbness. And generally, I'm someone who talks to myself a lot. Everywhere I go, on the road, in the house, which is really okay. I feel like, and also another thought is you feel like you should be worrying about something, but you don't know what it is. You can't, like, put a finger on it. And anxiety is silent. Note, anxiety is silent. You may be going through it and you don't even know what is happening to you. I went through anxiety. I did not know why I was feeling that way or what was happening to me until the day I went to a therapist. That is when I noticed that what I'm going through is anxiety. I'm still in therapy. One of the reasons why I went there is because of anxiety, basically. But I also have other reasons why I decided to go in for therapy. Living with anxiety, like, what are some of the things you struggle with? The first one is you struggle to get out of bed. It has happened to me a lot of times. You just, because of that fear of you're worrying about something and you don't even know what it is, you find it hard
going to
Another
getting
thing
out
that
of
people with anxiety battled with is fear of meeting new people. I had said that before, is you find yourself in the midst of new people, you're worried to even to unlearn your fears. The other one is worrying about social situations, quite obvious to many people, painful flashbacks. Some of the bad things that happened to you in the past or have happened to someone, they keep coming back to you. And there are some of the reasons that cause irritability. You get so irritable. We have repeating tasks to make sure that you're perfect. This has happened. Kitambo, it used to happen to me, but now I've gotten over it. That if you give me an assignment, if you give me a piece of work to do, I'll make sure that I keep going after it, keep repeating it to just make sure that I've done it to perfect. Another thing that people with anxiety battled with is fear of meeting new people. I'd said that before, is you find yourself in the midst of new people, you're worried to even to unlearn your fears. The other one is worrying about social situations, quite obvious to many people, painful flashbacks. Some of the bad things that happened to you in the past or have happened to someone, they keep coming back to you. And there are some of the reasons that cause irritability. You get so irritable. We have repeating tasks to make sure that you're perfect. This has happened. Kitambo, it used to happen to me, but now I've gotten over it. That if you give me an assignment, if you give me a piece of work to do, I'll make sure that I keep going after it, keep repeating it to just make sure that I've done it to perfection. Then we have difficult falling asleep or even staying asleep. Happens to me at times, but I know it's because of I spend so much time on screen. So yeah, then people with anxiety need reassurance a lot of time. That's why you'll find them repeating tasks time and again, because they need that reassurance that they're doing the right thing, they are okay. Because remember, these people have that fear of not being okay, not being enough, I mean. They have this fear lying behind there of, maybe I am not good enough. These feelings of insecurity, they are not sure what is going to happen. Then these are the kind of people who cancel plans at the last minute. And many people don't understand this. You guys may have planned to be somewhere or to do something. Then all of a sudden someone cancels and you're mad. It's not, people with anxiety do this a lot of times. They cancel plans at the last minute because they have been thinking about it and they honestly feel like they can't, I can't be in that event. I can't go to this place. That fear of what is going to happen. Then they overanalyze things or situations. That is quite deep. They look into things a lot of times. Then they are also, this is a funny one, they're the kind of people who delay replying messages for even days or weeks. Okay, I know there are those who use this as an excuse, but people with anxiety also struggle with this. So I'll see you guys in the next episode as we discuss how can we help persons with anxiety get over it. I'm also going through it with a therapist right now, but I'll share some of the tips that I personally apply to make sure that I am going through anxiety, because my anxiety levels have gone too low. From the time I started doing these things, they have gone too low. So I'll see you in the next episode as we discuss how can we get over anxiety. Thank you for watching. Until next time, please remember to subscribe to my channel if you haven't. Like, share, and comment. This means a lot to me. Until the next episode, remember to be kind. Check on your friends. Check on your family. And remember that your mental health matters. It's okay not to be okay. Thank you.